Engineering Department, present you Halpak, a paper by Aditya Manda and S. Logesh Kumar. Hull fouling. First of all, we should know what is hull fouling. Hull fouling is the buildup of oysters, barnacles and algae on the surface of the hull. What happened is, the ship's hull get covered with a biofilm and marine life get latches on its surface below the waterline. And what are the impacts of this hull fouling? There are two major impacts. There are ecological and economical impact. First, let's see about the ecological impact. In today's situation, the invasive species have become a very big threat to marine environment. The hull fouling is found to be one of the most significant mode of transferring invasive species into local water. These invasive species compete and contaminate these native species and cause the extinction of the native species in local water. Thereby, it affects the biodiversity of the many regions in the world. And due to the increased drag force and additional fuel consumption caused, there is an excess of fuel consumed by the engine and an additional emission of about 20 million tons is released every year into the air. And let's see about the various economical impacts that are caused due to hull fouling. The major impact is fuel consumption. Due to hull fouling, the drag of the vessel increases up to 10% and according to the DNV's statement, increasing 1% of drag leads to an increase in fuel consumption of about 3%. And due to the extinction of the native species, aqua capture has gone down in many regions. And this is one of the new and most prominent things which have been found in recent research, that microorganisms produce certain organic compound which causes corrosion in marine structures. So, what is the solution for all these? The best solution is effective, efficient and eco-friendly hull cleaning. How will we do it in today's situation? In today's situation, we use hull fouling paint, manual scraping method, high-speed water jets, ultraviolet light and hydrolancers. But all these methods have their own drawbacks. The hull fouling paint releases harmful chemicals and biocides, and earlier versions of hull fouling paint were banned by IMO. The UV light is a time-consuming process and has a risk of releasing paint into the ecosystem. Water jet and rotating brushes can be operated only with the help of the diver, which is so costlier. And final method is manual scraping, which is the most traditional method, but it requires frequent dry docking. So, where should we go? What is the next? Here comes the way ahead. Bio-inspired underwater grooming, the hull bug. What is it? It is an autonomous hull inspection system that provides innovative approach for autonomously inspecting and grooming the hull while the ship is both at port or at sea. What it has? Technically, Hullback has four main important systems. They are propulsion system, which is nothing but its motion control component, inspection system, which is nothing but its detector and mapping and navigation system. Motion control component. It has four 30 watt motor for propelling the device, and an additional motor of about 30 watts is used for grooming the device with a special per head gearing for speed reduction system, and a motor of about 200 watts is used for keeping the hull intact keeping the bug intact in position with the hull. And all the motors used here are DC motors with a maximum continuous torque of about 256 mN at a speed of 12,000 rpm. Let's see the detector system that is present in the hull bug. It consists of two main detectors, fouling detector and hull inspection detector. A fouling detector is nothing but a fluorometer. A fluorometer is a device that irradiates the surface of the hull with UV light and detects the presence of biomolecules, and thereby enabling the hull to be groomed only in the particular region where there is a presence of biofilm, and enables the bug to save a large amount of energy. and hull inspection system is used to detect both paint and plate thickness using the principle of magnetic induction, and even internal and external corrosion on the hull can also be found with the help of this system. Now comes the mapping and navigation system. The scientists have tested their heads a lot to make it navigate. They want multiple hull bugs to operate at the same time, so they create a large number of navigation modes and algorithms to enable it to operate by dividing the ship into different regions. Then comes miniature acoustic ranging sonar, which is used in the navigation of the hull bug, and another system of navigation use micro electromechanical system for navigation. Here is a video explaining how the hull bug operates. When the hull bug is deployed into water, with the help of its thruster, it directly goes and attaches itself to the hull and starts grooming. Once any technical problem comes or the charge in the bug goes down, it automatically goes back to its docking station where it gets recharged, or it gives an alarm to the person on board to note it. Now, a small study based on my assumption was made here by how much amount of fuel can be saved by using hull bug. Considering a bulk carrier owned by SCI, we found following details. The ship name was MV Alakananda and her deadweight ton was about 47,221 tons, and she has a fuel consumption of about 23 tons per day. And it was noted on the year 2010, she sailed for a period of about 330 days, and thereby she totally consumed a fuel of about 7,590 tons of HFO, which is IFO 380. Assuming there is an increase in fuel consumption of about 20% due to hull fouling, it would cost you about $1 million. Then it should be noted that about $1 million can be saved per year per ship by using hull bug. Because in today's situation, all other methods are getting outdated. Why hull bug? Why not any other method? The hull bug is the only system which is completely autonomous, and it requires minimum staff requirement. Compactness. That is a very small device. It is just 2 feet length, 2 feet width and 1 feet height, and has a very less weight of about 30 pounds, and even an unskilled labor can operate it. Biofilm detection. The biofilm detection in earlier days were done only through diver assessment or image acquisition, but in today's situation it has a self-assessment system which can find biofilm by itself. Plating and coat thickness sensing. Before, the plating and coat thickness sensing were found only in the dry dock. By using this system, it can be found in water, therefore it increased the period between dry docking. Conclusion. Huge saving, economical, eco-friendly, and most importantly, sailor-friendly system are key aspects of hull bug. This gives hull bug a huge leverage over other technology, affirming its superiority over current trends. It would be surprising if future marine ships were not practicing the use of bio-inspired underwater grooming device, as the report revealed hull bug will be grooming the vessel from June 2015. Thank you.
Anybody?
It has currently been manufactured by Ocean Naval Research of USA.
Okay, I have one question.
Yes, sir.
When you are in sea, when you are doing it,
yes, sir,
all the particles are being left into that environment. In the dry dock, it doesn't happen. There is a process of cleaning the entire residue,
yes,
and,
sir,
you know, collecting the trash. Don't you think that is harmful when, sir, you do it in sea?
Yes, sir. The only regulation for this in-water cleaning is ANSI code. According to ANSI code, the fouling of primary level can be treated anywhere around the world, and only secondary and tertiary fouling cannot be treated. Here, we are removing it in biofilm level, which is more lesser than the primary level. So it is applicable to the, it comes under ANSI code regulations. Yes, sir.
Why did you take the worst case 20%?
Sir, I found the digit would be nice if it could be higher. So it went for a very good difficulty. Because everyone
it'll be alarming. People will be jumping in the shipping companies if it is 20%.
Yes, sir.
The hull is clean.
Yes, sir.
So what we have done is, for all the 330 days, we have taken 20% increase in registration.
This
is not a very practical way of looking at it.
Sir, from where I took this value is, according to US Navy, they said about a 0.25% increase in skin friction will be about per day due to hull fouling. So I calculated after a year, it could nearly goes to 20%, and in the forthcoming next year, it would have this type of problems.
What paint scheme does this vessel have? Does it have the latest paint schemes?
No, sir. It is outdated. And what I was trying to say is, this type of scenarios would happen if there is no anti-fouling methods used in that.
In your conclusion, you have said this is the best and the best with respect to our other technologies.
Yes, sir.
And you said about our other technologies, can you name one or two?
Yes, sir. Nowadays they are using ROV, remotely operated vehicles for cleaning this. And anti-fouling paints, still they are in the development stage. So they were not able to provide us completely biologically safe. Whatever anti-fouling paints that were produced today have a small amount of toxin in them.
There is a little bit of shifting from the theme of the paper. So, you are answering the issue post it has been formed or before it will be formed. Your paper, as I understand, bug will work only if something is there.
No, sir. It should be operated regularly because.
No. On the day ship was launched on that day also?
No.
No. So therefore, your solutions are for post-scene.
Yes.
What happens, the natural which you are giving the answer now, the anti, the paints, or why we should think of different things. Instead of painting, we can have some other methods of putting the skin on the ship. Maybe it could be synthetic. So are you, is your paper addressing those issues or only after the hull is fouled?
Sir, we are trying to pre-treat it. We are not going for after treatment. What we are trying to do is, while it gets fouled in a beginning stage, on a biofilm, we are removing it, sir.
At biofilm level, you are treating it.
Yes,
but,
sir.
You need a biofilm to treat it.
Sir, biofilm is a substance that is formed when the hull is introduced into water. It comprises of all bacteria and those things which form, and over the biofilm the organism gets attached, because on a plain hull none of the organism can get attached.
And you are using it while the ship is sailing also, 10, 15, 20 knots?
No, sir, only on.
Only in the,
only on.
At the, when ship is at anchor?
Yes,